Hi there. Welcome back to the Learn Scriptcase from Scratch course. And we're continuing part four. We're actually finishing it up, looking at all the different applications. We've looked at a lot of different types. And now we've come to our last type, menu applications. So as you can see, after this, we're going to go into security and logging as well as deployment. So let's look at what menu applications are going to do for us. So as you know, we're using Global Music Supply as a case study, a fictional case study to kind of guide us through this. So I've created a lot of different applications to do all the different functionality. We've pretty much got all the functionality covered. Now we just need a menu to link everything together and provide easy access. So we've all seen menus. We've all used them. And Scriptcase makes it really easy for us to build them. So let's go over the Scriptcase now, our development environment, and get set up with menus. Okay, so we're in our development environment in the root folder. We've got all of our different folders with different applications organized in them. Now we're going to go to new application to create a menu to link all these together. So wait for that to load and then we can select a menu. So there's two types of menus in Scriptcase. One is a tree menu and one is a little bit more modern horizontal menu. We're going to do our horizontal menu for this course. So we can do that. So we've got our menu. We're going to leave it as menu for the name. Go ahead and click create on that. And go ahead and wait for it to load here. And once it loads, we can start adding elements to it. So menus can be pretty simple, but you can add a lot to them. We're going to keep it pretty simple for this and just add some menu items. So this menu items section is the main area. And you can see a preview of the menu down below. So that maybe doesn't look how we want it. So let's go ahead over here to the left. And we've got menu themes so we can make it look however we want. Let's go ahead and choose this theme. This is one of my favorite themes for menus, but there's a lot of themes that you can look at and use for yourself. Let's leave it as is for now on that theme. And let's start adding elements. So to do that, we need to click the addition sign right here, the green addition sign, and then add our first item here. And so the first thing we need to do is set the text for that, and that's going to be inventory. And then we can link it to something, but that's going to be a main menu item, and then we can add something below it. So we're going to add admin, that's another main menu item. And then the next one is going to be reports, that's another main menu item. So we're kind of organizing it by our folders that we have over here in our home tab. So we have admin, main is going to be inventory, reports, and then sales is our fourth main menu item. So that's our main menu items for now. And then we can add sub menu items below those. So let's go ahead and hit save on that and then get started with our sub menu items. So once that's all saved, let's go back up to inventory here. And as you can see, there's no links or anything, but inventory, and then we're going to add an item below that we can link. So click the addition sign below. And then that's on the same level, we need to bump it in one level. So to do that, we can do that in just a second, but we're gonna go ahead and set this up first actually. Let's go ahead and type in the text. So this is gonna be the grid for instruments, and then we link it to that grid for instruments, right like so. So we're just gonna link our grid applications right now. So find our grid instruments right like so, click import, and we're ready to go, and then we need to bump it in. So let's go ahead and click the left arrow there to bump it in. Now it's added to do that. So now we're going to do the same for recordings here. So I'm going to speed this up just a little bit. And then the same for sheet music. Link it as well to our sheet music grid. Click import. And then as you can see down below, we have it all set up. Now we could make this look a little bit nicer with some font awesome icons. So to do display, we set font awesome, and then we can search our font awesome icons here for something music. So there's a drum for instruments, and do the same for records here. So choose the records, change the display to font awesome, and then for the icon, search for our something, the record perhaps. So there's like a microphone, so that might look kind of nice. So this is just making it look a little bit nicer. We're not going to do this for all of it. Let's do font awesome again and search for something for sheet music. So there's some music notes there that make it look a little bit nicer. So go ahead and click save on that. And then if you mouse over the inventory section of the menu down below, you can see those icons there. So that makes it look a little bit nicer. Now let's add our items for admin. So that's genre, media type, and category. So those are our support applications. So let's start with genre, import that. another item below it. Let's do the media now. So these are form applications. We didn't set up grid applications for these, form media, and do the same then for category. So that's going to be text of category, and link it to our category category form, like so. And that's ready to go. Then reports, we're going to link one of our chart applications and then one of our PDF applications that we created. So there's our instruments chart and link it to our chart instruments application, right, like so. And then one more here, let's do our PDF. So let's do our instruments report like so. And then link that, that's actually our recordings report, not instruments. Make sure we name it correctly there. And that's our PDF report recordings like so. So that's under the reports option now. And then the next one is sales. So we have these sales. We're going to link our input sales, our calendar, and our sales intro applications to this. So three applications. First one is going to be our instructions here for our that we created with our blank applications. So that's our sales intro here down at the bottom here. Let me find it, import it here. And then one more, two more actually. So input sales. So if they don't need the instructions, they can go straight to the input sales application there. And then our sales calendar there. So let me name that sales calendar like so, and then link it to our calendar application that we created. And now our calendar should be pretty much, our menu should be pretty much set up and ready to go. Let's go ahead and save it. And then we can go ahead and run it here. We've got a couple more settings that we're going to change, but let's go ahead and run it now. So we can see what it looks like. So wait for it to generate, and then we can go over to that application, wait for it to draw on the screen. So there's our menu with our different options. And if we click one of them, it's going to load right in the area there below the menu. And we can click another option here, and it's going to open up another tab for that and load it in there. So then we can switch between those tabs very easily. So that's very nice and helpful for us. But if we close all these tabs here and on the initial load of the application, we have this big blank area that's kind of bare. And we can control what's in there with our initial application. So we can go to settings and change the initial application settings there. So wait for the settings to load here. And there's a lot of different settings that you can do on a menu application. We're not going to get into all of them for now. But if we scroll down to the bottom, the very last setting here, we have our default application. Right now it's blank. We can link it to a URL or one of our applications in our project. We're going to do that one application and then click the link here to link it to our dashboard application. Our dashboard application is going to look very nice in that. So let me choose a dashboard right here. So choose dashboard and then click import. And now when we run this, it'll load our dashboard application automatically. So there we have a nice clean layout that has all the information. So wait for that to load here. And then our dashboard application is going to load underneath that menu. So that looks very nice, has a lot of functionality there. And then we can go and run one of our applications like we would expect. So that's how you set up menu applications in Scriptcase, and then set up a dashboard and load all those applications within tabs in your menu.